My name is Maria Franey. I'm a junior biochemistry major, and I am from Murraysville, Pennsylvania.
So how do you balance all that you do in your life?
It is a little hectic. That's always hectic, what am I saying? But I guess if I were to say how I balance it, I definitely stay organized. So I have a lot of color coding in my life. So I always try to write down assignments, keep track of assignments, and that helps me keep on top of my academic work. To deal with everything else, I try to write down dates as soon as possible when I learn something is coming up, so that way I can work around conflicts. The main thing, really, that helps me through is my faith, because otherwise I'm pretty sure I would be crazy right now. I would not be able to juggle everything that I do, because I always try to find in what I'm doing, why I'm doing it, and making sure that I'm not just going through the motions of something, busying myself with things that aren't actually bringing anything to me and aren't bringing something to someone else.
How do you think God has helped you to succeed in college so far?
Oh man, so many ways. I guess I would have to start with freshman year, honestly, because I didn't actually want to come to St. Vincent. It was kind of one of my backups, because I had these big ideas of me going to, you know, Ivy League schools and all these great programs. My parents loved the idea of St. Vincent because it was close to home, it was Catholic, and it was a small school, and basically all these things that I was not interested in. Not that I didn't love my Catholic faith and that, you know, I wanted to get away from my parents or something, but there was that part of me that really wanted to get out of my small town and go out somewhere else, you know, hours away and see what a different part of the world was like. And then, as luck would have it, several different things happened, and St. Vincent ended up being the best option for me. As I went into the fall semester and I actually got to meet the students that were here with me, I really got to see how beautiful it was and how much the faculty and staff cares for the students. So it was like, God was like, hey, this is actually really where you need to be right now, and just all these things started to fall into place. I was being much more outgoing than I was in high school, just with meeting new people and just going to events, you know, completely alone during orientation weekend. There are a lot of ways that I try to connect with my faith, prayer and contemplation, and also in more active ways. Campus ministry has been absolutely amazing on campus with that, because I've been able to really get involved and not only participate in things, but also lead certain things, and it's just given me a lot of opportunities that I have never been presented with before. So that has led me to kind of have separate parts of my life where I'm able to make that connection and further my relationship with Jesus. And so that's in ways of silent prayer, if I just want to go on a walk or to the Basilica or to the chapel and spend some alone time with God and have my own prayer time where I can pray for myself and others and anything and everything, so I get to have that time. Last summer I got to go on the Taiwan and China mission trip, so that was really cool. I got to work with a lot of amazing people and just get to meet all those different people and see where they are in their lives, how their lives compare to mine, and how God is present in their lives and also mine. It brings us together. So many wonderful things.
Do you have someone or people who have influenced you in your faith?
Definitely my parents. I mean, I was a cradle Catholic, so I grew up in a big Catholic family, and I was Catholic all the way up from my baptism until now. If I asked them questions, were willing to engage in conversation with me. As I got to high school and obviously into college, and I was starting to think about, okay, this is what I was raised with, but is it what I myself believe? And I was able to delve into the questions of doubt and uncertainty that I had, and able to actually look into what it meant to be Catholic and to make my faith my own. And I think my parents were definitely big players in that, because if I did have any doubts or was confused on something, they were always very open to discussing it instead of just saying something like, oh, that's the way it is. If I'm called to marriage and I'm called to have kids, I definitely think that I would want to raise them in an environment where, number one, they know that they are loved, not just by me, but by God. And the reason that they are loved, you know, is just because they're them and they exist. They don't have to do anything to earn that love. It's just given, and it's freely given no matter what they do.